I want to show you two ways to make a scrunchie with a sewing machine. The first way is unique and an interesting way to make a scrunchie. There are hundreds of sewing tutorials on making them, but this technique I'm about to share with you now is kind of unique and not found in many videos online. But it's a fast and easy way to make a scrunchie. And you will get an awesome final product. There are no visible seams and it looks professionally done. And the second way is kind of common, but the scrunchie itself is oversized. So I hope the tutorial will be helpful to you. And I would like you to comment after the video which way is better. What way do you prefer to make a scrunchie? Hi, I'm Olga. If you like the video so far, click the like button below to save your video in your liked videos folder on YouTube. So, why make scrunchies in the first place? This project is perfect if you are just starting out sewing or looking for something fun and simple that doesn't require much fabric. There are no complicated techniques involved. The best part about making these scrunchies yourself is that they will be unique and personalized, so no one else will have the same ones as yours. You can find the perfect fabric for any outfit and have fun with designing. And if something doesn't seem right, you can always adjust things like the length of the elastic. What you will need to make a scrunchie. Piece of fabric for scrunchie. It's better to use natural fabric for this scrunchie, like 100% cotton. Piece of fabric for embellishment. Piece of regular elastic, 7-8 inches. Sewing machine, regular sewing notions. And use threads of matching colors. For this scrunchie, you will need one piece of fabric 20 inches long and 4 inches wide, and one piece of fabric for embellishment 20 inches long and 2 inches wide. These are the sizes I used for my scrunchies. The strip of fabric for embellishment is a very useful addition to the scrunchie. Why? Because the scrunchie will keep its shape better with it. You can cut these rectangles right on your fabric, or you can draw it first on paper and then cut from fabric. Press the fabric before cutting to get all wrinkles out of the fabric and make it nice and flat. I'm using a rotary cutter and a cutting mat, and in this case you don't even need to draw the rectangles on the fabric. You can use the grid lines of the mat to cut perfect rectangular shapes. Here I have them cut. Fold these pieces right sides together. I like to use pins to hold them together for stitching. We need to stitch these short edges. Seam allowances are 3/8 of an inch. Don't sew over pins. After you are done sewing, carefully press the seam open. Fold the narrow piece, this one from embellishment fabric. Fold it lengthwise in half, wrong sides together. Use pins to secure the fold or just press it with a hot iron. I'm using spandex fabric. I can iron it, of course, but for now I prefer pins to secure the fold. And now pin this piece to the big tube, right sides together. We need to attach this embellishment and seam allowances are 1/4 inch. Okay, done. Now turn this tube wrong side out. Now comes the trick. Fold the prepared piece like this. Well, it's hard to describe, but you can see how it's done. We have to take these two layers away from the stitching line. Let me show it to you again. One, two, like this.
And now the edges, pin them right sides together. Now pin two outer layers together. Make sure that you don't pin the folded inner layers. Start stitching this tube. Seam allowances are 3/8 of an inch. Stitch until you are close to the folded edge. Let me change the camera angle. Now we are at the folded edge. Pull the inner layers. The inner layers are coming out, and we need to arrange them manually and continue stitching. We do this a few times until we are close to the start of the stitch. At the back, the fabric is, well, scrunching. So do it like this. Now we came to the start of the stitch. Leave about 1.5 inches not stitched for turning it right side out. So now we have this shapeless piece. How do we make it a scrunchie? Well, easily. Turn the scrunchie right side out through this opening and press. So we almost have a scrunchie with a small opening on one side. Now we need to insert elastic to make it a scrunchie. Use a 7/8 inches strip of elastic. I used a 7 inch strip. Usually you should be able to twist the scrunchie twice around your hair. If your hair is thick, you might want to use a longer strip. But don't forget that you will need to overlap the ends of the elastic to sew them together. How wide is the elastic? I used 3/8 of an inch elastic, but 1/4 inch and 1/2 inch wide elastic can be used. Usually I secure one end of the elastic strip with a pin, so I don't lose the elastic as I feed it in. When you are finished, both ends will be accessible through an opening in the tube. Try to make sure that the elastic hasn't twisted inside the tube. I usually use two safety pins for inserting elastic, one safety pin on each end. Take the two ends of the elastic, overlap the ends of the elastic and sew them together on the machine or by hand. The elastic should not come apart when you use the scrunchie, so the ends must be properly sewn or tied together. And now my scrunchie is almost ready. The only thing that's left is this hole. Hand sew the hole if you want a nice seamless finish. Close the opening using an invisible ladder stitch. I have a detailed tutorial on how to do an invisible stitch by hand, so check it out. Now, let me show you the other most common way to sew a scrunchie. But not a regular scrunchie, but an oversized scrunchie. Do you like oversized scrunchies? They're the newest trend in hair accessories. They are cute, they keep your hair out of your face, and they don't get stuck in your hair like rubber bands sometimes do. I made a few of them for different dresses. First of all, choose the fabric that you like most. Cotton, silk, satin, or velvet are great choices. I'm going to use 100% silk fabric that was left after I made a dress. These are the measurements for the oversized scrunchie. Cut one rectangle from the fabric of your choice, 40 inches by 9 inches. Press out all the wrinkles to make the fabric nice and flat. So, how do you cut the rectangle from silk fabric? There are many ways to do it. You can draw it first on paper and then cut it from the fabric, or you can draw the rectangle right on your fabric using fabric markers and then cut. But the fastest way is just to rip the fabric. Of course, not all fabrics can be ripped, but my silk is very easy to rip. And in the end, I will have a very straight piece of fabric for my scrunchie. The ripped edges are curling a little, but they will be flat after I press them with a hot iron. And the short edges are easy to cut. Don't forget to cut the selvage edge. Now we are going to sew the long edges first. So fold the rectangle in half lengthwise, right sides together. Secure the fold with pins. But we need to leave about 2 inches on each side of this piece without stitching. You can mark the beginning and the end with pins or fabric markers, so when you go to your sewing machine, you remember where to start and stop. Okay, start stitching at about 2 inches from the edge. And the seam at 2 inches from the other edge. Secure the seam with back stitching. Seam allowances are 3/8 of an inch. Now you have this tube of fabric. Turn it right side out. As we are making an oversized scrunchie, it's easy to turn the tube just by hand. Line up the short edges of the tube and pin them right sides together. Not very comfortable to pin them, and so we need to sew the two sides together. Seam allowances are 3/8 of an inch. Iron the seam when you are done stitching. Now it's time to insert elastic. The process is exactly the same as I showed you with the first scrunchie. Hand sew the hole in the stitches if you want a nice seamless finish. But it's also possible to sew the opening using your sewing machine. Tie up your new oversized scrunchie around your hair and enjoy wearing it.
In my next video tutorials, I will show you how to make a scrunchie that lights up and also a no-sew scrunchie like this. Please comment below which way to make a scrunchie you prefer, and also subscribe to my channel. See you soon, and thanks for watching.